Good morning, students. Yesterday we have started the topic flexibility. What is flexibility? I have given you the definition. What is a type of flexibility? That is active and passive. What is active? What is flexibility? Passive and what is passive flexibility? Whenever you are able to complete a particular range of motion, particular movement with the help of others, that is known as passive flexibility. And when you are able to complete that movement by yourself only without taking help of anyone, that is active. So once again, the definition. Passive flexibility is the ability to perform a range of movement with greater ease through external help. Through external help. Passive is external help. And this is by oneself only. By oneself only. Active by oneself only. Now there are two types of active flexibility. One is static. It is the ability to perform a movement with large amplitude while remaining in static position or constant position, that is while sitting, standing or lying, if you are able to complete that position or motion, a range of motion, that is known as static. What is dynamic? It is the ability to perform a movement with large amplitude while body is in motion, like jumping, running or kicking. When you are able to do that flexibility, complete that range of motion, range of movement in motion, that is known as dynamic. When you are performing that range of movement in that is known as static. Now there are different types of methods how you can improve your flexibility. In this chapter, we are dealing with the different components of fitness. Right now, we have dealt with what is strength, what is endurance, what is speed. Similarly, we have seen what are the different methods. What are the different methods to improve your particular component inside you. Like for endurance, it was fartlek, continuous, and interval. For strength, it was isometric, isotonic, isokinetic. Keep this in mind. Whenever this question comes, Don't write that okay, by going to gym, by doing weight training, by eating green leafy vegetables. That is something different. This is my technical terms. What you should do to the basic physical fitness component. Hari sabzi khane mein taqat aa jayegi. Khana khao to bhi taqat aati. If you are eating your nutritional diet, then also getting power or strength inside. But how to improve that particular component? These are the methods how to improve, but how to get. So what is ballistic method? Ballistic method. In this method, the movement is performed with rhythmic swinging in the maximum range that can be obtained. The involved joint is stretched. The involved joint is stretched with the swing, keeping the count in mind. Keeping the count in mind. That is known as ballistic method. Now second method is static. What is static stretching? In static stretching, the muscle is stretched to its maximum level and then gradually released. For example, if you are lying down, now you are being told, okay, raise your leg, and then somebody pushes it to a particular level where you feel the pain. That is known as static stretching. Once you feel the pain, then you say, okay, now gradually it will come back. Similarly, for the upper body, put your hands at the back and slowly raise your hands. Like for this, we are saying, raise your hands up with the help of other person. And once that movement is released, you cannot move more than that. Then, after that, hold it and again come back to this normal position. Gradually, slowly. Not that it was okay. It can give you injury. Slowly raise your joint at a particular position. After that, once you feel the stretch, once you feel a pain or a stretch, then after that, start bring it down. Now, dynamic stretching method. This method uses active muscular movement that brings about stretching, but it is not hold in the end position. It is not hold in the end position. This takes soft tissue to their full length. And then after a brief pause of 3 to 5 seconds, it is again brought to its normal position. It is again brought to its normal position. Now, post isometric or PMF. This method is based on proprioceptive neuromuscular facilitation. PNF technique, which raises the active passive range of position, active and passive range of position, and improves performance. The muscle is first contracted maximally till a particular level. Here you will feel the pain. Then you will hold it for 6 to 8 seconds using isometric method. Then stretch to specific limit again. यहाँ पेन हो गया, ओके यू आर यूजिंग योर हैंड्स, यहाँ पेन हो गया, होल्ड इट अगेन, एज होल्ड इट फॉर 6 to 8 seconds, अगेन स्टार्ट यूजिंग योर हैंड, सो दैट स्लोली एंड ग्रेजुअली योर फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी विल बी मोर एंड मोर. दैट द मेथड्स बाय व्हिच यू कैन इंक्रीज योर फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी और योर फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी स्ट्रेचिंग मोर एफिशिएंटली फॉर योर डायनामिक स्ट्रेचिंग. द नेम ऑफ पोस्ट आइसोमेट्रिक स्ट्रेच इज आल्सो दिस पीएनएफ स्ट्रेच. इट इज आल्सो नोन एज पीएनएफ स्ट्रेच. Now, there are some guidelines which you should follow to improve or develop flexibility. Warm up is necessary in the morning before playing or before playing any activity, whether running, jogging and all that. Warm up is compulsory by one or the other method. Then only you will be able to flex muscles at a particular end. Okay, I will get them, okay, and then in simple words, before playing a competition, if you don't play the competition, what are the risks? The chances of injury are more compared to when your body is warm, because your temperature has risen up, the temperature is warm up compared to what was earlier. So warm up necessary for performing flexibility exercises in order to avoid overstretching of the muscles. When you are doing stretching, you will not come to know, okay, that muscle has overstretched because your body is not properly warmed to the use. Okay, let it come. But what happens? Because of this, the overstretching of the muscle takes place. Quick and sudden movements should be avoided before the muscles have warmed up properly. Quick and sudden movements should be avoided before the muscles have warmed up. But same thing. Warming up should be done properly. And slow and deep breathing will help performing the stretches. For successful development of flexibility, the exercise should be repeated 2 to 4 times. Suppose, okay, we are seeing the lower body stretch and upper body stretch, okay, hands up, down. But in your yoga, you will say, okay, I'm flexible, I improve my flexibility. Should perform that set of exercises 2 to 4 times, then only you will be able to get the proper set what you want. After that comes exercising the relax, varying the position in which you can stretch, keep on changing the position while doing stretch. While again and again you are doing the same stretch, that is you are giving the stretch to a particular muscle from the whole body part which is required. For example, you should be able to as your body separated in front of the thigh plus hamstring, back of the thigh. So you should be able to perform an exercise of both in front also and in back also. That is body set as well as hamstring. Then comes stretching activity should be done at least 2 days every week. Then you can't say, okay, today I have done, after 15 days I will do that, my flexibility will be same. No. It is flexibility from more and more if you are doing the exercise regularly, if you are doing the exercise more and more. Minimum days to practice, times of week. Then comes the hamstring, hip flexor, calves, and chest muscles often get tight. Each of these can be stretched by you. Similarly, hamstring, chest muscle, when you are doing exercises, they get tight. So you should be able to do that proper stretching for these muscles so that they will feel relaxed and you are able to recover properly. Now, last topic, what is happening in this coordinative abilities? Coordinative abilities that will be dealing tomorrow. One more chapter, one more topic is there, that is circuit training. What is circuit training? When you are doing exercises, when you are doing different exercises. You make different stages, doing different exercises. Like here you are doing, here you are doing exercise for the upper body. Three junctions you are doing for the lower body part. So this is more circuit. This is a circuit training. Or you make a circuit for performing different types of exercises. You make a circuit for performing different types of exercises for different body parts. Like here you start using this. Here you display what to say. Push-ups. So that your upper body part. Now here you are doing the temporal lifting that barbell. Here you are doing exercise. So it comes. The question comes that which make a circuit for the whole body, for the development of body parts, for the lower extremity, for the strength of the lower extremity, for strength of the upper extremity, upper body or lower body. You have to make the circuit in such a way of evening. For the 10, they ask for 4 exercises, 1, 2, 3, 4. The circuit in the time. If they ask for 6 exercises, then you have to rank 6 exercises. It comes, how many exercises? Generally, it comes. Yeah, how many number of exercises will be given? So we have, but this year CBSE has removed this topic training in the course. CBSE removed the topic of circuit training in the course. Chances are that it is not, but we'll discuss it later on. So now we are done with the topic of what is forced training, performing and getting ready for any task. So getting trained for any task that is not training. Regarding physical education sports. So before the sports, what we are doing, that is sports training. Now what was endurance, what was speed, what was first of all, was strength. Really, the ability of the body to hold resistance. Methods to develop strength, isometric, isokinetic. What is endurance? Ability of the body to continue to the work under the condition of fatigue. Now there are types of endurance, what are the methods to develop endurance? Continuous, that means you are running continuously without taking any break. Interval, you are taking break, but you are decreasing the time. If the time of recovery is less. And what is partly? Where your running process for a deep running is not decided. You decide on the the track on which you are running. Suppose on the road, if you are running, you will be running fast. On the sand, you are running, you will be running slow. On the hill, you are running, you will be running slow. While coming down the hill, you will be running fast. So, the course of running will be decided by the track or on the path for which you are running. After that, came speed. They were how you can develop speed. That is by 2 ways: acceleration and pacing. Acceleration or pacing. Start from best example of acceleration. Start from jogging, then run, and then sprint. Jogging, running, and sprinting. That start from G and reach to the next thing. And in the last 20-30 minutes, start accelerating and maintain it. What is pace run? If you are able to run the whole race with the same pace. That is called pace run. If you are running the whole race and use the same pace, and this can be seen, the best example of this can be seen 800 meter power race. 800 meter power race is where the pace will be tested. is running with the same pace from the start till the last. And but in 100 to 100, they will start from little of from zero phase till they will be giving its maximum. They will go to the maximum race. Now in the flexibility, what was that? What are the types of flexibility? Active and passive. Under active it comes dynamic. Yeah. What are the methods to develop flexibility? Balanced, dynamic, static, and post isometric stretch. Other name of that it is followed on the concept of PNL. Followed on the concept of PNL. Facilitation theory. Okay, hold it at 60 seconds and having more flexibility and more regular and again hold it so that the flexibility pain. Once you feel the pain, hold the air 60 seconds and in static you are coming down, but again you raise your arms or legs to a particular level where you feel the pain again and then again hold it. By this way, you will improve the flexibility. There were few methods that okay. If you are doing the exercise for that, for example, if you are swinging arm forward also, swing the arm backward also. Similarly, if you are doing the stretching for hamstring, do the stretching for quadricep also. With antagonist or agonist, you are swinging arm forward, similarly, at the same time, swing the arm backward also. Then both the muscles are being used fully. Both the muscles are being used fully. Also and the backwards for the guiding principles. Now last topic is quality of activities and the strength. That is going to be now next class. Okay, students.